Hi everyone, welcome to Mom Inspired. In this video, I'll share a short testimony about why I love the Daniel fast, what is the Daniel fast, how to do a Daniel fast, my experience, challenges, advice, and some tips for you. I just finished the 10-day Daniel fast, and I can't wait to share this with you. In case you are new to this channel, I talk a lot about fasting. God has done amazing things in my life, and that's why I share them on this channel. And I know that if he could do that for me, he can do for anybody. What is a Daniel fast? In case you came to this channel and you don't know what a Daniel fast is, this is a fast that Daniel did in Daniel chapter 10, verse 2 to 3. He did it for 3 full weeks, which is 21 days. That's why you see people doing it for 21 days. And in chapter 1 and verse 12 to 13, the Bible is talking about 10 days. You can do this fast for 10 days or you can do it for 21 days. The first thing you have to know is that this is an opportunity to draw closer to God and also help your body get healthier. You know, as human beings, we are spirit, soul, and body. So you cannot have your body failing and expecting your spirit to be strong. I've created a video in case you want to know more about what a Daniel fast is. I'll put the link in the description box. So here is why I love to do a Daniel fast. When I had cancer, I went through chemotherapy for over 6 months. After I had finished, my skin turned gray and my hair was falling. My body was painful all the time and I had headaches like every single day. I looked so bad that I was even scared to look in the mirror. And by God's grace, one day I was praying and the Holy Spirit prompted me to read the book of Daniel. And I started reading chapter 1. And you know, when the Holy Spirit is the one leading, he will show you what he wants you to know. And on that chapter 1, I realized that Daniel ate fruits and vegetables and drank only water. And that did something to my spirit. It was like the Holy Spirit was saying, this is it. So I read the whole book of Daniel. After Daniel fasted for 21 days and ate only fruits and vegetables, his body and his mind were found to be excellent. And I knew that that's what I needed. So I started to eat a lot of vegetables and fruits and drinking only water. I did it for over a month and my skin started to change. I had dark marks under my eyes and all that went. We serve a very wise God, and the Bible has solutions to every problem. In that book of Daniel, it was like God was saying, treat your body like a garden. You know, you cannot water the garden with any chemical that is going to kill the vegetables or the plants. You help the garden to flourish by watering it and making sure that the soil is fertile. So yeah, that was my revelation from God in that book of Daniel. And the rest is what you see today. Before I started my 10-day Daniel fast, I made sure that I knew what I wanted. What I did was to plan what I was going to be eating on this Daniel fast. And I put up a list. I made sure that it was fruits and vegetables, but also I wanted to add some beans and lentils, especially at night for my bean soup. That helps a lot because you won't be running around looking for what to eat. I made sure that I went to buy some food, so I'll show you what I got. So as you can see, I got more fruits and vegetables. And I also bought some lentils and beans and some nuts, seeds, and olive oil. You can choose the fruits and vegetables that you like. You don't have to follow exactly what I bought. This is to give you an idea. In the morning, I would eat just an apple and drink some water, sometimes a banana. You can make a smoothie and add all the greens like spinach. You can add your seeds and nuts. It's up to you. But don't make it so heavy that your body now gets more tired, because you know that seeds and nuts are full of fat. To me, fasting is about overcoming the flesh. Fasting is the sacrifice. When I'm fasting, I like to feel hungry because I know that that pushes me to go in the presence of God. And if you are full the whole day, it won't feel like fasting. Daniel was on vegetables and water only. And on these 10 days, I made sure that I ate more fruits and vegetables. I would make bean soup at night for dinner. Yes, I did that a lot. Now let's go to challenges. Challenges? Yes. There were so many challenges in these few days. The Daniel fast for me was like a mental training, because, you know, you wake up and you don't eat the way you want to eat. I know people do it for 21 days. Mine was just 10 days, but I didn't know what to eat next. I ate a lot of fruits and vegetables, and I was like repeating the same food. I got out of ideas. You have to be very creative in the kitchen. And sometimes I was feeling so weak. I would make my bean soup and I'm like, am I going to eat bean soup again tomorrow? So those challenges are there. Yeah, sometimes you are like, should I snack on this? There was a day that I thought, let me just, you know, eat some fish. And my husband was like, you can eat some fish. I'm like, no. Daniel didn't eat fish. That is mentally challenging. You eat, but not really getting full. So that is a mental training, and it's good to adjust sometimes. It's wonderful to go on such a fast so that you see your mental strength. At the same time, your spirit is getting stronger and your body getting healthier. So those are the three benefits I got from this Daniel fast. Just say, this is the time that I'm sacrificing all these foods and I want God to show up. That should be motivation enough for you to move on. And so I came to the end of the 10 days just a few days ago, and I'm feeling great. My advice to you is that if you're on this fast and you're breastfeeding, eat properly, because you need more nutrients. Remember, you are eating for two people. That baby is depending on the food you are eating to grow. And if you have a medical condition, make sure that you see your doctor, because going on a diet like this can affect your cells, can affect many things in your body. You should make sure that your doctor has given you a go-ahead to go on this fast. So I've shared my experience and challenges, my advice, and some tips for you to do this fast effectively, and God will do the rest. If you've done a Daniel fast before, I want to hear your comments. How was it? How was your experience? And what were your challenges? Share in the comments below. I pray that your Daniel fast will be successful. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and support this channel by subscribing. Stay blessed, and I'll see you in the next video.